In Iraq, the humanitarian situation that today we witness is extremely concerning. More than 3 million continue to be the number of internally displaced people in the country, and the humanitarian assistance so far being provided by humanitarian actors, UN agencies and international organizations definitely does not meet what are even the basic services which the population of Iraq today will need. We are particularly concerned when it comes to the central part of Iraq, which is the area where the conflict has been raging for the last 2 years, and where still we do see pockets of population located close to front lines, where access to services, access to medical care is extremely difficult. And this is where exactly we are trying to have our team deployed to make sure that those vulnerable, those whose access to care is hampered by the political fragmentation that exists today in Iraq, can at least have a basic access to health services. The MSF response to the current humanitarian crisis in Iraq has extensively expanded over the last 2 years. Today we have on the ground almost 80 international staff and almost about 1,000 Iraqi colleagues working in 12 out of the 18 governorates in Iraq. We are providing primary health care services focusing on sexual reproductive health, non-communicable diseases and mental health. One of the most important is related to the fact that we don't see humanitarian assistance scaling up as much as the military operations continue in the country. And that can be a huge problem when it comes to the unification of Iraq and to the reconciliation process. Today it's extremely difficult to work in Iraq, particularly for our national colleagues. It's clear that the current conflict is also exacerbating the sectarian divide, not only among those fighting on the ground, but of course also on the Iraqi civilians, on the Iraqi population. We do value very much the commitments that our staff is having in really striving for providing medical assistance, regardless of the sectarian identification that it might have, but they are very much and increasingly ready to go towards areas close to front lines, but where it's clearly acknowledged the needs are the biggest.